Hey, what's going on, friends? Thanks for tuning in to another Smashcast. This is going to be episode number 7. And I've got a little bit more of a black metal kind of a theme going on today. Been kind of feeling that mood. So I hope you're in the mood for that. I kind of felt like the last couple years since I've dove down into such depraved cavities of death metal that my black metal friends have kind of been like, let me know when you come back from there. So this is maybe kind of a statement to claim that I'm still listening to black metal. I've been more in the mood for it lately, as it were. So I have 10 tracks, mostly black metal, kind of some long songs here too. It's just kind of the way it worked out. I don't know. Hope you like. Been hearing some good feedback on the last episodes from various friends here and there. I wish I had the 6,500 subscribers that I had on YouTube that I do here on the podcast, but obviously I'm starting this up from pretty much out of nothing. But this has been super handy, a super nice way to kind of keep creating content, keep doing my nerd stuff without as much work as the YouTube channel has been. And also, like, I've said this in a previous episode of the podcast, but like, I tend to buy the stuff that I want to talk about on my YouTube channel so that I can show it off in a physical format. It's all about a physical format. But here on the podcast, it's more about just having something awesome to listen to, which I think is kind of the other side of the coin. And I'm really enjoying that I can kind of do both. But anyways, I'm going to shut the fuck up and get on with this. So this whole episode was really spurred on by this next band that I just kind of discovered. I've been seeing the logo floating around, in kind of demo circles and shit like that. And I thought, that's a cool logo. I should check in on that sometime. So today, I saw it pop up and I was like, ooh, I'm going to listen to that again today. And so this is the band called Sorg from Stockholm, Sweden. And I am finding that their demos are impossible to find for download or stream or anything. But there's this one track uploaded to the YouTube channel for some techno label. I don't know. This is the last song on the last demo by Sorg from 1998. And I cannot fucking believe how cool this is. I just got done listening to this track like 5 times in a row. I'm not sick of it. It's so good. I want there to be a million bands that sound like this. The parts sound so different from one another, and that's what I think I loved about the Stockholm black metal scene. Like, there's cool parts, but they're so different from each other. There's such a variety and diversity within this track. So I'm going to shut up. Listen to Reign of Agony from the third demo, 1998. Fuck yeah. We'll be right back.
Yeah. Right. Thank you.
And there you go. How did you like that Sorg? Let me know. Let me know in the comments. I thought that was so good. So yeah, Sorg. And then after that, I had a band called Odal from Germany. Their 2002 release, Sturm is Brut. That was the track War. I love that stuff. And then the third one in that little pile there was a band called Forest Silence with The Eternal Winter. That is a cool Hungarian band that is it's not a solo project, but it's a side project of the keyboard player from Seer Bliss. And for some reason, Seer Bliss is cool. I've never really gotten crazy about them, but I've always been pretty crazy about a handful of this guy's solo projects. He's got this ambient project called Arud, A-R-U-D, which is really cool. And then he's in this thing called Nefarious. They have a 7-inch out. I should just put a Nefarious track on a future episode. That's what I'll do. I'm mark my words. Anyways, so that was Sorg, Odal, and Funeral Siren, Forest Silence. And so this next group, I'm going to start it off with a band called Uvia. This was kind of one that I just spurred on this episode as well. I haven't listened to this album in a long time, but when it came out, man, this thing was, it's so underrated. I feel like a lot of people don't know about this album. They caught on kind of big around 2017 or so. They're kind of... The last release that they put out was like a triple 10-inch kind of thing, and it was super limited, and then pre-orders sold out in like, I don't know, an hour or something. And then when everybody, I think, got their copies of it, they found that the sleeve that the 10 inches had been stored in had sand in the envelopes as if to intentionally damage the records. And I just thought that was so fucking aggravating and stupid. And if you don't want people to buy your physical media, don't fucking make it or sell it. What a waste of plastic. But the album that preceded that one, Eternidad Solemna, was really good. And I'm going to play the second track off in there called Vientos de Olvido. This is a Mexican band. But I don't think I've heard a lot of like atmospheric bands from Mexico. This is not thrashy at all, not 80s at all. Really kind of heady, rainy kind of stuff. So a couple more tracks for that, and I'll come back here and I'll give you a big old hug for listening to my bullshit. We'll be right back. I have this thing where I make a decision about like what song to put on something, or I want to recommend a specific album to a friend of mine or something. And I think that's brilliant. What a perfect match made in heaven or something. And then the next thought I have is, I've probably already had this thought, or I've already picked this track out for a playlist somewhere else, or I have this deja vu kind of thing. I've been doing this for so long and recommended so many albums and songs to so many people that I feel like I've probably already put a Dream Death track on my brand new podcast. I don't know. I've just been really coming around to that Dream Death album, Journey to Mystery, over the last couple of years. It's always a good time. It's always a good choice to listen to Dream Death. I need to get my fucking hands on a copy of it. I just can't decide if I want it on record or CD. That's what's stopping me. And it's kind of not easy to find. So yeah, in that last bunch, we had Yuvia from Mexico. And then one of my favorites, you've probably seen me wearing my beloved Darvulia shirt. They're one of my favorite black metal bands. And that track, that's just one of my favorite albums of black metal. They're so perfectly weird and angular and dissonant and just bizarre. Fucking haunting as all shit. So that was a bunch of goodies. Next time, I've got a big pile of long songs here for you. So we're going to start this next one off with War of Conquest. The album is called The Magic of Long Forgotten Empires, and I am not going to even pretend to pronounce the song title. In my first episode, I think, of the Smashcast, I played a band called Visceral Evisceration. And there aren't a lot of like spin-off bands from Visceral Evisceration, but one of the guitar players was in this War of Conquest band, and I've just kind of been meaning to check it out for a while, and then I discovered this new, actually I think it's about 2 years old, new to me podcast last week. The name is escaping me. Bunsen Burner Recordings podcast or something. It's on YouTube. It's on Spotify. It's on everything. But they get into some nerdy shit like I do. So I really appreciated finding people out there who were talking about Visceral Evisceration 1 and 2, that they even knew about this War of Conquest album. So it's weird, great riffing, just oddball kind of symphonic black metal kind of stuff. And then the track after this is going to be from a band called Mutant, Swedish stuff. When I thought about putting a Mutant song on a podcast, so it was born. Then a couple more after that. I'm going to come back after this giant pile of goodies and just going to see how you're doing, check in on you, and hope you get sent off on your merry way quite well. So here we go.
Yeah.
Just thought I should let you know that since I'm doing a black metal Smashcast today, I do have a candle lit at my side. So there you go. Bringing the mood to the Smashcast today. And in that candle, there is a little bug burnt to a crisp along the side of the glass, morbid and dark as you could possibly fucking believe. So, what did you think of War of Conquest? Pretty cool. Pretty weird stuff, huh? And then Mutant. God, I love that song. That dude can riff like it's like the heft and the complexity of death metal riffing, but he just has a nice slick kind of black metal sound. And then after that, this band called Mephistopheles, which is a German band. They have a couple of albums out. That was from the album Song of the Desolate Ones. That's just kind of always been a go-to. Love that album. And then the end of that was the shortest track that I could find from Funereal Presence. I've kind of feel like we might be due for another Funereal Presence here soon. We got a Negative Plane album last year. And I don't know. I just kind of hope there's something coming up the pipes from Funereal Presence. Because that last album was phenomenal. So that's going to be it for me. I've been toying with the idea of putting together a Favorites of 2023 episode. I was going to do a year-end list, and I always say that, and I'm not. But I do just want to put just a playlist together for Spotify, highlighting some of my favorites. So that will probably be the next episode. And so yeah, keep an eye out for that. Thanks as always for the support. As always, if you like some of this shit, go buy it. Look it up. Support it. Talk to other people about it. Spread the shit around. Play it again. Play it in your car for somebody else who might like it. Like, share, subscribe, all that shit. And then, as always, if you want to support this thing that I do, any of the weird things that I do, you're welcome to hop on over to Patreon and throw me a couple bucks and say thanks for what I do. So, as always, take care. Till next time. Hail.